it's really early outside.
I don't really want to be awake, but today the plan is to drive 3 hours down to Tennessee to hopefully find some really cool salamanders, so let's get on the road. So me and Sam have been hiking this ridge for about 45 minutes now, and we got a little off track, and then right down the ridge, the first rock that I checked after we found our way back. I can't believe what I'm looking at.
This is the main goal of the day. Big, healthy, green salamander.
So we've been scouring these rock crevices for about an hour, and I was starting to think we might not find anything today, but on the way back down this hillside, I checked a small little outcropping right here and found my lifer green salamander. Now these guys are really cool because they're almost their entire lives in rock crevices. So they hibernate in rock crevices, they feed in rock crevices, and the only other times they really come out is when it's raining or at night. So almost their entire life they spend in these super small crevices. Hmm. Now, one of the cool things about these salamanders is that people are starting to learn that they're actually a little bit more arboreal than they thought. A lot of research is now showing that they actually live in trees a lot during the summer months. So there's still a whole lot we gotta learn about these things, but you know, I'm excited to finally see one in person.
Number two.
Really small one this time. That was a pretty successful first stop. We ended up getting two green salamanders. Woo! And now we're gonna go hit our second spot, hopefully get some more lifers. Don't you listen to the never. Honestly, can't kind of believe what I'm looking at right now. It took 5 trips, 4 different spots, and like 3 states, but I finally got my lifer mud salamander. Now, this is actually a subspecies of the mud salamander called the Midland mud salamander. They live in mainly the Midwest, to Southwest Virginia, Tennessee, West Virginia, and parts of Ohio. And they live in these seeps and springs and super muddy areas, as their name entails. And look very similar to red salamanders, except they have these super black eyes, and their black spots are a little bit more spread out. But this is an absolutely stunning salamander. It looks just like a ruby. You wouldn't even think these guys live in the mud, but they do, and this is the most amazing salamander I've ever seen. I said my seep senses were tingling, came up to this awesome looking seep and flipped a Sam's Lifer four-toed salamander and another Midland mud right next to each other. I honestly can't believe what just happened. This is absolutely insane. Some sort of unidentified frog. I can't tell if it's a really weird looking spring peeper or a mountain chorus frog. It's a mountain chorus frog, it'd be a lifer. So after some looking at some field guides, we're pretty sure this dude is a mountain chorus frog, which is lifer number four for me today, lifer number five for Sam, so.